it's your girl Bondi Blue, and I am back for another Black and Crew Chicago review, y'all. So let's just go ahead and get right into it, because the episode started off where the last one left off, which is with a big blowout between Kat and Ryan, in which she sprays the whole shop with the information that she got her box ate out twice a day last summer by Ryan, okay? For all of that lightweight shit he talking. For all of that, we just had a kiss at the lake house shit he be talking. Yeah, like I told y'all, kissing on the clip. I ain't got time for Ryan and his bullshit. And you know you wrong when you the one that leave. Talking about, I mean, she a woman, I can't put my hands on her. All I know is when I come back, bitch better be gone. And I'm like, nigga, you know it's not gonna work like that. You know it's not gonna work like that. You already said you didn't want her in the shop, and Van still brought her back into the shop and keep bringing her into the shop. Why do you think that any of that is gonna change just because you came in and yelled at somebody and took your cast off? Like somebody gonna be scared. Talking about, I don't understand why they don't understand this is my shop. Because you never assert yourself. Every time you have an opportunity to prove a point, instead of proving that point to let them know who the real owner of 9 Mag is, what you do is bitch up and give everybody their way. And that, my man, is not how you gonna prove that you a boss, okay? But Van don't give a fuck. Van said, you gonna have to get through him to get to Kat. You gonna have to deal with him to bully Kat. And I'm like, nigga, you only saying that because you the only one that ain't fucked her. Mm-hmm. Don't think we don't know, okay? And Donald don't have time for this bullshit, okay? Donald got other shit that he's worrying about. But for Ryan, and now Lily have all fucked Kat. And I think Van said he made out with Kat at some point. But either way, like, you spreading yourself kind of thin, homegirl. You know, close quarters, bitch. Stop shitting where you eat. So Four and Nikki are getting acclimated to life as a couple living together with their cute little dog. And Four is still on this, I want a baby. You know, we got this fire crib. I got me and my queen. All we need now is a little princess or a little prince. Nigga, didn't you hear her last time when she told you that y'all ain't about to have no baby right now? You ain't about to fuck up the bodaciousness of Nikki's body right now? You ain't about to do it. No baby, no baby, nigga. Like, damn. You know what I'm saying? That's how she feel. But she definitely wants to have a housewarming party. A lingerie. Lingerie. Okay, housewarming party. And wants everybody to be in there pussy popping with their lace on. And I'm just like, girl, you the main one that's flipping out whenever somebody shaking their ass in your man face with lingerie on. But she want to have all the hoes in the house? Girl, I get you. It was a fire party. We're going to get into it in a minute. So Don pulls up to pick up the baby in a new Benz truck. And I'm like, common sense would have told you, man, don't bring the new Benz truck around the BM that's got to raise the baby by herself. She was going to feel some type of way. I just knew she was going to feel some type of way. Before he even walked in, her homegirls in there like, oh, Don just pulls up in a new Benz truck, bitch. How he gonna pull up in a new Benz truck? He ain't got enough money to help me take care of this baby. It was just straight up off rip BM issues. When he goes inside to pick up the baby, she like, can I help you? He like, yeah, I'm just coming to get the baby. You know, my weekend, whatever, whatever. She like, oh, well, it's not your weekend. You can't take a cup. Then they start to argue. Then the baby start crying, bad daddy. And I was just like, that is fucking sad. That is despicable. I was so mad at Whitney, whatever her name is. I was so mad at her because I understand how you feel, but what you not gonna do is impress that upon that fucking baby. That man never pick up his child. He's there to be there. And you mad because he didn't bought a new car for himself. Bitch, come on now. Pull it together. I understand, but pull it together. So he ends up leaving without the baby, right? So him and Ashley have a little sit down or whatever. They have ice cream with their son, who is so adorable. And she wants to know why he never came back with the little girl. And he like, look, man, she tripping. I pulled up. She all mad about my call and all of that. But I feel like I might have to go through the court system to get this shit together since she want to act like this. And the angels must be whistling Dixie out this bitch, okay? Because Ashley was like, I don't think you need to do that. I'm like, Ashley, Ashley has really grown as a person. Ashley is one of them people that probably watched herself the first season she was on here and corrected. I can appreciate that about you, Ashley. I really, really can. I really love how you and Don have pulled y'all shit together as people and as married people and as parents. I'm so here for y'all, okay? Ashley said, I don't think you should get the courts involved because I respect her as the mother of your daughter, and you need to just figure that out as an adult, and that's that. Oh, bitch, if you don't get the slow clap, okay? I'm so here for Ashley, and she was absolutely right, okay? Don was at the house chilling with his son, and Ashley comes home from work, I guess, or whatever she was doing, and Forrest there, and here come Whitney driving up with the baby, and she said, I thought about it and I was tripping and I'm sorry, you know, I was in my feelings, because you got to understand, as a single parent, this shit is hard. And of course she's going to feel some type of way when she see the man that she really wanted to be with, husband to this woman. He's a great husband, seemingly, at this point. He's a great father, always. So she was feeling some type of way about having to be the one to struggle and do it all herself for the most part. Even though he's there, when she go home with that baby, it's just her. When he go home, it's him and Ashley. You know what I'm saying? So I understand how Whitney felt. And I'm glad that she got herself together and realized what was most important. And that's for her little girl to have a relationship with her father. That's the most important fucking thing. Okay, so hats off to their little blended family. I'm here for y'all. So to say fuck you to Ryan and be politically conscious in a black way, okay? Van invites Trayvon Martin's father and another teenage boy's father who was killed in to get tattoos, okay? And y'all, I don't even feel like getting into my emotions right now because I have so much on my heart when it comes to this world and what's going on with you know, police brutality and people getting killed, but also with the stuff in Libya and this newfound African slavery that they put. Y'all, it's just so much going on in the world right now. And it really was like a moment for them to be young, gifted, and black, okay? I'ma just go ahead and tell y'all right now, they did excellent on those tattoos. And I was just all in my emotions about it. Let me tell y'all something. Trayvon Martin's daddy has to be a special type of man to be able to walk on this earth without fire coming out of his fucking head every day, okay? Because George Zimmerman is still walking around free, being a total dickhead, while his son is lying in a grave. That shit right there would eat me up on a daily basis. I don't know how I would be able to function walking around thinking about that all the time. You know what I'm saying? So my hat go off to the angels that are sitting on Trayvon Martin's daddy's shoulders. Okay? Real shit. Okay? But this was a fuck you to Ryan because Kat was there to partner in the tattooing with Van. He found that out because they posted it on social media to show him. Fuck you. We doing tattoos together at the shop and you told us not to. Fuck you. Like, it was real shady, even though it was such a great thing what they did. But he's not gonna be happy. He's not gonna be happy. What don't they understand? He don't wanna have to work with the female that his woman knows he cheated on her with. Like, that's really the bottom line. Back to Neek and Charmaine's tumultuous relationship. Because one day they in a good place, and the next day you want to punch Neek in the face and slap the shit out Charmaine for allowing him to fuck with her mind like that. But you can tell Charmaine was one of them slow girls in school that grew up to be pretty, but still kind of slow. So she'd get with a smart nigga that's an engineer who liked to, you know, play with her intelligence, if you ask me. He don't tell her that he just signed up for a job in Africa that's gonna take 6 months. And when she was like, I mean, well, babe, you ain't even talked to me about it. You can't get a job that won't take you away to another continent for 6 months? And he was just like, man, you really need to just chill out and stop thinking about yourself. Like, really, you really need to just trust me and, you know, get over it. And I was just like, wow, wow. His response to her was so cold. Like, he didn't give a fuck about her feelings. He don't give a fuck about their relationship. But then just two or three episodes ago, he getting on her about how much she work and how she needs to bring more of her attention towards him. See what I be talking about? Bullshit. You trying to control somebody. Fuck Neek. I don't like him, okay? I don't like him and I don't fucking care. To combat said African trip for 6 months, Charmaine decides that she's going to take Danielle and Kat to a jewelry store so she can buy this nigga an engagement ring to keep him from leaving. Midnight, is you stupid? Seriously? Thank God Kat and Danielle are good friends and was like, no. No. You really want to do that? You don't think you're moving too fast? That's a lie, bitch. He needs to do that for you. Okay, this is not the life and this is not the way. I felt some type of way because I just knew she was going to embarrass herself. All the ladies go lingerie shopping with the exclusion of Cobra. So that's, and Ashley. So that was Nikki, Van's old lady, Jen, Lily rolled up in Junior's truck. So they still fucking. Nikki even invited Danielle, Charmaine, and Kat there. So everybody's trying on lingerie, having a good time. And we see some attraction brewing between Kat and Lily. And I'm like, oh, you nasty bitches. We about to see. So everybody's chilling in the shop, having a good old time. And Ryan wants to come through with a vengeance. Because he just saw the pictures that they posted online with Kat and Van doing Trayvon Martin's daddy and his partner tattoo, right? So he come in there like, bro, what did I tell y'all? I told y'all I don't want her working here. Y'all fucking with my life right now. And Van, Charmaine, Danielle, everybody is trying to have Kat's back and let him know that the only reason you don't want her here is because you doing dirt. You was fucking with her and you don't want to admit the whole truth. He said, I admitted what I did, but I don't need this extra stress trouble. She cannot work here. Point blank, period. But what he fails to realize is neither Danielle, Charmaine, or Van ever listen to what the fuck he says. They do not identify that shot as his. They identify that shop as everybody's shop. So nobody is really trying to hear what he's trying to say. Then Ryan gets all in Van's face because Van is like, man, fuck you. That's my homegirl. She gonna work here. Kat is not mad. This is her home. All of that hoopla bullshit. In real life, he should have fired everybody with the exclusion of Dining Four, who were the only two people that didn't have nothing to say about this situation. Danielle, the way you go so hard, bitch, you don't need to say nothing either, because I find it very that you and your homegirl both fuck Ryan. So if I put my job in danger to have Kat back, that's just what I'ma do then. Girl, what? Nothing happens. Van is not going to listen. Ryan is still gonna punk up and bitch out and allow whoever wants to come in that shop to come in that shop, because he never asserts himself as the boss of anything but various bitches' pussies, obviously. So the lingerie party hit off hard, and Nikki and Forrest place your dick. They got the fireworks popping. They got the bitches in the lingerie popping. Niggas in dirty robes. We here for it, all right? The party is going off. And my favorite part about the party was Don and Ashley being the old married couple standing in the corner laughing at everybody else. I wonder why Ryan ain't here. Don't even get me started. Like, they was cute as fuck being a little messy couple in the corner talking about everybody else bullshit. I thought that was too funny, right? Then Junior and Lily get into it because Lily comes out on the balcony and Junior chilling, and he was like, damn, you had to come in here like that? You had to kill him like that with the lingerie? And she like, so what you trying to say? I can't dress like this? What you trying to say? You like own me or something like this and I can't dress like this? And he like, bitch, I'm giving you a compliment. Time out. That turns into an argument. And once again, Junior is tired of her and her crazy shit. Yeah, right up until that dick get hard. I don't want to hear that shit, Junior. I'm tired of y'all with y'all back and forth. Like Charmaine said, pick a side, okay? Everybody is getting drunk. Everybody is getting fucked up. And Charmaine decides she wants to give a speech. Drunk as fuck, okay? At first, the speech was directed towards Nikki and Four for inviting everybody for this fantabulous affair. Then we moved on to pulling the ring out, and everybody's like, no, it was a collective. What the fuck is going on? Don was like, what the fuck is she doing? Everybody was like, no. We was watching it, looking at each other like, why is she doing this? She drunk as fuck. Somebody help her. No help came. No help came. That bitch got out on one knee and proposed to him. And everybody was just like, oh my God. He laughed it off. He picked her up and said that was his job and this is not the time or the place. Katrina comes over and says, y'all, I think Meek is the real MVP because he would have been a bitch ass nigga if he would have put that ring on his hand and been like, he would have been a bitch ass nigga. So we just want to say whoop whoop for Nick for being a real man and saying that that's his job to propose. And I'm like, yeah, right. Let's save face and act like that's what it was. Right. Go ahead. Fuck out of here. That was embarrassing as fuck. But Charmaine's so drunk, she don't even care. She was still trying to propose again. They picked her up and ushered her ass off. And she was just like, at least I tried. And I'm like, bitch, you look stupid. Then shit changes speaks. And Kat and Lily decide that they gonna make out in the kitchen. That make out in the kitchen turns into, won't you come back to my place? And I'm just like. did y'all see the way Ford and Don and Van was watching? Oh my God. Y'all, everybody love Kat and she's gotta have. So, the last part, you guys, is about Don's sister. Don got a phone call that his sister committed suicide, jumped off a boat into the river and died. And, y'all, I was crying. My heart was broken for him. And the part that was so hard, because I've had those thoughts. Even though I didn't have a bad day yesterday, I was driving home yesterday before I even saw this and was like, what if I would have pulled this car over and jump off this bridge? I actually thought about it for a second. I kept driving, but I thought about it. And the fact that I get home and watch this episode, this girl actually does this. And to see the look on his face and just the pain of you couldn't help. You couldn't do anything. There was nothing you could say to make it okay for her, to make her feel like this wasn't the alternative that she should have taken. This wasn't the choice she should have chose. Y'all, my heart broke so hard for Don. It really did. I swear, when it rains, it pours out this motherfucker. But yeah, y'all, it was sad. My prayers go out to them. They got one more episode next week. I think it's one more episode. I'm supposing it's one more episode because Black Ink Crew New York starts next week too. But they also have one more episode left of this show, Chicago. So, yeah, you guys. Ending on a somber note. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel, Care Bear. Share. Okay? I love y'all and I'll see y'all in the next one.